right, let's visit now with Dallas Owens, who's team organizer, team everything. Kind of reminds me of my wife because she really runs the family in our situation. But Dallas, I know one thing right now, that you had to have grown up in a very, very nice way. So tell me a little bit about growing up, your hobbies, your interests before joining Blue Arrow.
Sure, yeah, I appreciate you having me. I'm glad that I reminded you of your wife. But so, you know, growing up, I grew up in Knightdale, which is right outside of Raleigh. I've been here my entire life. Hobbies growing up was really, you know, mostly around the outdoors and sports, so hunting, fishing, and then played soccer and football, baseball, track and field, really any sport that they had at the school I played. So that was pretty much what I did in all my free time growing up, and that's all stopped since pretty much, but yeah.
All right, tell me a little bit about after high school days, continuing your education. What happened after that?
Yeah, so after high school, I went to East Carolina, and I studied finance there, and was part of the business school. I had a really, really good time, learned a lot, and graduated in 4 years, which is, you know, that's the minority at that school, so it was really good.
Absolutely. So, you know, I don't want to say anything about party school or anything like that. They have a good football team, though, anyway. But how did you become a part of Blue Arrow Telematics?
Yeah, so about, I guess, 3.5 years ago now, you know, I approached Stuart and I, you know, kind of saw what he was building. And I thought it was a really cool business. And obviously we're really a lot different, you know, 3.5 years ago. We've changed a lot, but I thought it was a really cool industry. And I just approached him and asked him, hey, I'd love to do sales for you. And here we are 3 years later.
Absolutely. All right, Dallas, tell me about, well, you talk about that role, but I'm sure you got many other roles here at Blue Arrow.
Yeah, so I mean, I'm mainly focused on the sales side, but you know, Stuart asked me about a year and a half ago to help, you know, do some internal things, schedule meetings, really lead our internal meetings to make sure they're beneficial, educational, which the main goal of that is to make sure that our entire staff is really staying ahead of the curve in our industry. So whether that's just, you know, general industry knowledge or different product knowledge or, you know, how to speak to customers and really lead the conversations in beneficial ways, there's really a lot of different topics that we talk about, but really lead those, you know, those meetings. And then I do a lot with our vendors as well and coordinating new vendors. If, you know, if I see something that may be a good potential solution for us, we can bring to our customers. So kind of all across the board, honestly.
Okay. So is there anything typical about a typical day? These little compartations of different responsibilities?
Yeah. So, I mean, a typical day is primarily talking to customers. I mean, I'm talking to customers probably 80% of my day or prospective customers for us, with a few internal meetings sprinkled in here or there. But really what I enjoy doing the most is on the phone or in person with our customers, talking about their business, what do they need, you know, how can we help their business, you know, move further in into the future, and really just help them in general cut their, you know, cost and also increase their profits as well.
All right, Dallas, you know that this is a fast-paced industry. It's ever-changing. Telematics is incredible, and it's evolving each and every day. So what are you doing to help Blue Arrow keep ahead of the game?
Yeah, a few different things. I mean, I enjoy just general business information, so I try to stay very up-to-date on just general business things that are happening in the world in general, which I think helps me really understand where a lot of our customers are coming from, understand their concerns, what they're also, you know, looking to the future for. But in our, you know, in our industry specifically, I am a part of this thing called NAFA, which is I'm doing a certification for fleet management. Really, all the really large companies in the country, they hire out of this program for their fleet managers. And really, it just covers a lot of different areas from financial management to maintenance management, to understanding how to be a leader in your organization. So really, I'm just trying to be really on an even playing ground, excuse me, with the folks that we're talking to.
Okay, so that means you've got great customers that you interact with. So if you had any suggestions for your customers about how they can maximize their return on investment, what would it be?
Yeah, I think there's a lot of things that people can do to maximize the return on investment. But to me, from what I've noticed in all of our conversations, the number one thing is involving the drivers and getting the drivers on board with what you're trying to do in the company. Because a lot of companies, you know, they implement different programs, they never involve their drivers, they use it just as a negative, and they see much, much less return on investment. And I promise you, the companies that do involve their drivers regularly protect themselves from a lot of litigation and also save themselves tons of money when they get those drivers on board with their company objectives.
Good advice from Dallas Owens. Blue Arrow Telematics, give us a call.